30 games in the postseason, 6 Super Bowls, far ahead of the next closest duo in that Super Bowl era. Dan, tell me this. Do you have an issue with how Brady Belichick's relationship ended?
Absolutely not. I'm surprised by people who are so shocked by this. Greatness is not comfortable. They're the two of the greatest to ever do it. Quarterback-wise, Tom's the greatest. Coach-wise, Bill's the greatest. So there's so much discomfort that goes on over 20 years. I kind of admire it more. I appreciate it more now that they were able to go accomplish what they did. These are two of the most intense, maniacal preparation-wise, egotistical guys that have ever come through the NFL. And they were still able to put all those differences and seeing things differently and maybe not agreeing on everything to the side and to go accomplish the goal, not only for them, but for their organization, for their team. And as much as I've appreciated them going to accomplish that, now kind of seeing some of the stories that have come out and maybe there was some discomfort or bad blood there, I admire it even more because they never let it get in the way. They never let that go and deter them from going to win 6 Super Bowls. And as Lewis Riddick pointed out this morning, there are a couple plays from winning 9. And so I can appreciate it. And the reality is that this is a high pressure, high intense job, both coach and quarterback. And for those guys to get through what they got through over 20 years, and I'm disappointed, I guess, that it's going to sour some people's opinions of what has happened, but it makes me appreciate what they accomplished even more.
I got to admit, Dan, I'm kind of disappointed in your take, in all seriousness. I really am, because I think that, you know, you don't just know your football. You know it so well, you're a teacher. And I think that this could be a teachable moment for a lot of people. Yes, Tom Brady was 219. In 64 as a starting quarterback for the New England Patriots in his years there. Yes, he won 6 Super Bowls, went to 9 Super Bowls, and obviously Bill Belichick was his coach. Without the services of Tom Brady in New England, Bill Belichick's career record as a head coach for the New England Patriots without Tom Brady is 36-30 as we speak. Mm-hmm. We understand what they did together, and we get all of that. But there's something to be said for a level of excellence that they put forth, and, you know, Molly alluded to it yesterday in terms of how things should end. And I think blame could be thrown in the direction of both individuals. And I think that's important to highlight and illuminate. For example, if you're Bill Belichick, all things are not created equal and everybody is not the same. You wanted to treat Tom Brady like you treat any other player. Mm-hmm. This is the same Bill Belichick that once cut a dude when his family showed up for him to be in the Super Bowl. He had to end up watching the Super Bowl from the stands with his family because you cut him right before the Super Bowl. Some would say that's heartless. Malcolm Butler gets into an argument, according to excerpts from this new book coming out. And as a result of that, because of that argument that he had with the defensive coordinator, that had a role to play in why he benched him for the Super Bowl, even though he was the leader in snaps played for the defensive unit for the New England Patriots. And Tom Brady, despite putting up 33 points, ends up losing a Super Bowl to the Philadelphia Eagles because Nick Foles drops 40 on them. That has something to do with it, okay? So we see that Bill Belichick can be relatively heartless. That's not a lesson that we want everybody to reap from this. We should be celebrating the greatness of Bill Belichick, the coach and the executive. Unfortunately, what we're lamenting along the way as we talk about him and we probe deeper into what's transpired between him and Tom Brady, we're looking at a man and we're saying, damn, I mean, all business. Some people are accusing him of being relatively heartless. And if he doesn't find a way to win, now that Tom Brady is gone, who knows whether or not that's going to be his epitaph. Long before he passes away, this is just what people are going to say about him. On the part of Tom Brady, here's what we have to look at. We so religiously, Dan, focus on his greatness as a player, as we should, that some would say they should have treated better. And so when you look at it from that perspective, even though Tom Brady is revered, and even though you recognize his greatness, and even though you appreciate all the things he accomplished and all he did, there was a lot of things that players should have never tolerated that they had no choice but to tolerate because the leader in the face of your franchise, Tom Brady, tolerated those things as well. And then he finally speaks up indirectly or whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
Now that it was his turn to suffer some of the circumstances and the consequences that he had to get exposed to with Bill Belichick. How come we don't think about that?
Well, here's my thing. When you say it's a great learning lesson, I agree. I think it's a great learning lesson for everybody to realize that we're not always going to get along and see everything the same way.
Totally.
But if we can kind of understand that there's significantly greater goals for us to go accomplish, you can once you move the ego versus the ego problem. So I agree, it's a great learning lesson. And Stephen A., we can't like hold Bill Belichick to the fire when it says, well, he was real cutthroat or heartless because he placed winning at the very top level. And no matter what and no matter who, he was going to keep winning the most important thing. And we can't kind of like say now, well, that was a little kind of harsh, so to speak, but then somewhat praise Tom Brady for it. Tom did the same stuff.
Well, that's what I'm saying. That's exactly what I'm saying. And what I'm saying to you, Dan, is this. It's if it were over, like let's say, for example, Tom Brady had retired. Okay, you're absolutely right. The problem is Tom Brady had more time left to succeed. And so we're looking at a guy still in the midst of his career, still at a championship level, ultimately having tired of being treated that way. And that's what makes this so compelling. We could sit back and celebrate both of them if all we have to lean on is that they won together. But when Tom Brady leaves and is still winning, ultimately you're asking yourself, Bill, damn, you had to be that way and push that brother out the door? And then you look at Tom and you say, okay, so now it's intolerable because it's you. But what about the other cats that were pushed out the door that you facilitated Bill Belichick being able to do that because you were the standard by which players were treated because he treated you that way so he could get away with treating anybody that way.
I know we have to move on soon, but Dan, we left off the major detail that we were discussing yesterday in terms of how this ended and that Brady wanted a meeting and that Belichick talked to him on the phone and how there was a little bit of disrespect there. And then at the end of the day, that Brady wanted to stay in New England. He was the one that and Belichick was the one that wanted him out.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.